extra, I'm still with the gang and we're dissing, oh boy. So first thing, Shiba's concert is coming down, 3rd of December. Crazy! You're a Shibaholic? But there's something I actually wanted to talk about. Yes, I don't understand Shibaholics. I saw a guy with a big tattoo of I am a Shibaholic.
Oh,
I asked myself, this punk also promises
somebody
he's going
around here knows him. Yes,
you know him. Tell me that guy is going to get married and then you wake up with boy and the next morning and all you see is like, I'm a Shibaholic. That's just great.
But what is it about Shiba? Huh? I actually have a friend.
A spiritual.
West African, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But the guy likes Shiba. He says, get all Shiba.
She's light-skinned.
No, that doesn't cut it.
She's a guy.
She's ratchet.
He's a
guy. Oh, come on. You can't tell me all guys just
from
look
West
at
Africa.
Like. Oh,
my dear. My dear.
From West Africa.
She being ratchet is not a turn off.
It is not a turn off. It's a turn on nowadays.
Yeah.
When a girl is ratchet.
Yeah.
They love her. The more ratchet you are, the more the guys will love you. We're not looking for trophy wives anymore. We're looking for chicks who are going to go up to the club and they're like, so my bae told me that he can buy me bottles of champagne like every day. And then her man is going to their baby. It's okay. You get what you want.
But what are you talking about? But you have Ivana Trump, or what's
she's
her name?
She's in the White House.
And she's in the White House.
God save us.
You have this other one. What's her name? Kanye West,
Kim Kardashian.
No, that is one.
Kim Kardashian.
The other one
Amber
in look. Uh huh. That
she's
one even has
Tanzania,
a.
Tanzania, by the way. That was just. That
please.
Just
ratchet
it
works, by the way.
When you're ratchet, you make it. But please. The thing about Shiba, I don't get, and her followers, I feel it's spiritual. You know, if you're not feeling it spiritually, it can't make sense to you physically.
My dear.
This is what Shiba does for followers. I'll explain to you.
Please do.
Shiba walks into a club.
Uh huh.
And then a bunch of people come and surround her like Shiba fans.
Mm-hmm.
And if your guys, she's going to dance with each of you.
Kati baby,
nkwatako.
Rubber dab, one on one.
She's going to take pictures with you in turns. That is why Shiba fans are really Shiba fans.
I think the only thing that would
they're
make
like
me
Arsenal
a Shiba fan.
I'm even liking her the most.
Yeah, that's
they're like Arsenal. Did you just refer to Arsenal on this set?
Because I don't know.
Abadabada.
I was just in trouble with my book because of Arsenal last weekend.
Arsenal.
Yes, by the way.
But that's besides the point. Now, her concert is coming up.
Okay.
It's going to be, of course, a killer. Because like you've said, she has her fan base. We had thought about the fact that Jeff Chiwa will not do his concert on the same day that Wizkid is supposed to do his concert. But nah. Why did you just breathe out?
Shiba was going to take a whipping.
No. She wouldn't. Now that's a thing you don't get. The love that Shiba has in UG is crazy. We would not go see Wizkid who's been here twice.
True.
With Shiba, you expect
some
skinny
Ugandans will actually
go
for Shiba, not to go for Wizkid.
But
on the bright side, Wizkid would have been paid already.
So it doesn't hurt the Nigerian economy.
You understand? But guys will go for Shiba. Trust me, man.
Man,
we've done events in this country. Guys, we go for Shiba.
They would definitely go for Shiba, so there is no sigh of relief.
Shiba is strong.
But let's move away from Shiba. I'm just waiting to see how that concert goes down because it has gotten a lot of media coverage. Let's move on to more serious things. So Jackie Chan Diru apparently is not doing so well. Don't laugh. Try to be good with yourself. Jackie Chan Diru apparently, after her drug situation, rehabilitation, treatment and all of that, she came out, she was strong, we were like, yay, Jackie has beaten it against all odds. And the next thing we hear is like she's relapsing again. The other weekend me and Kevin were asking ourselves, what kind of drugs did this girl take that are still in her system? And that is not even just the approach. When people like Jackie show up, it makes me think about different people. I think about Winnie Nwaji and the match drugs she's taking. I think about Radio and Weasel. Those guys can smoke up a tree. I think about people like, do you think Gravito Mutuju does drugs?
See, the difference is this. The Radio and Weasel, maybe Winnie Nwaji, weed.
Who say?
Weed, I'm just saying.
Okay.
Weed is okay. You can smoke.
It's an herb.
A pound of weed.
And be okay.
But now, the drugs that Jackie Chan reportedly was using.
Which drugs were reportedly?
I don't know.
Meth?
Just saying.
Because when I heard there was crystal meth in the situation, I was like Breaking Bad all over again.
See? Now that is the kind of drug that will make you relapse.
Weed.
And this is the thing. She's not relapsing to take the drug again. She is nursing wounds from her usage. It messed up her skin, it messed up everything, and I was asking myself, how did anybody let it go this far? Where is that white guy that they had a secret wedding with? Do you know nobody has talked about her?
Those guys.
White guys run from such situations.
And he keeps paying the bills?
Huh? He can probably build us the problem as long as his name is not attached to what is happening.
That's your wife.
Actually, I think the guy ran away.
He
dropped her. I don't know.
Those guys will drop you, by the way.
White men run from such situations.
Once his wife did, he wiped it.
I can explain to Kevin in the band, be like, you're sitting now, that's my wife.
Yeah.
But she's dragged up and I dumped her.
Yeah.
But we're still cool, we're still doing
like
business.
Like, we are.
But you're not sitting next to me, you're over there.
Was that his first wife?
You see that?
Of course not his first wife. He's got issues.
The guy himself one is drop this one now.
What happened to Jackie Chan? She was such a talented girl. What happened?
Who said Jackie was talented? Jackie
to
me.
She was talented, man. She did Gold Digger. No Ugandan has ever done a song like that. She got an old school version of a song and brought it back into the urban style, which Ugandan never
played. So after Gold Digger, what else?
Hey, Michael Jackson went down at one time. Things
I
happened.
Know, but after how many hits?
Huh?
After how many hits, boo-boo?
And how does this even chick get the money to keep on doing this joke?
That is what I'm saying. Y'all trying to say that the white guy is not in the situation, but she could barely afford. Her career wasn't taking her anywhere. So where was she getting the money from? It only turns back to one person. Husband has money. He's white. He's a pensioner. Who is financing?
Did you guys know that the most people who are hooked up on drugs are the brokest people? Go down to the gutters, you find guys who can't even
afford a meal
twice a day,
but they're hooked on drugs because of situation.
Exactly. Yeah. So those people who do drugs.
But then again, now let's just live alone with Jackie's Chandiru's situation. Let's ask ourselves, with the industry and how it is such a hard industry to hack in and stay a part of, people like Keiko have beaten drugs and I see her doing her thing. She's back in studio. She's all good. And she feels that we are being unkind and very cruel by always associating her to drugs. But here's the thing. I want people to get the wake-up call, especially celebrity in Uganda. We shall not stop talking about drugs because at one point, they make these people ambassadors for different things. You'll find so-and-so is an ambassador for this brand, for this youth, for this, that. And they're trying to be nice. But we all know y'all is drugged up as hell. So I'm not going to stop talking about that fact that all of you do drugs. And if we were to run a drug test on the media industry here, the industry that, let's say the musicians here.
All over the world.
Ah, baby.
APAS will pass.
Not just here.
APAS will pass. You know how his name is called Puff Puff Pass? A-Pass? A-Pass?
Bebekul will pass
too. Bebekul, yes. Bebekul.
He will pass.
Who else? Bebekul he will pass. He doesn't do drugs.
Really?
He's just naturally crazy.
Okay. Naturally. He's naturally crazy.
Yeah.
Psychotic.
Okay, that is...
So who else would pass
here? That explains a lot.
Aziz Azion?
Desire Luzinda.
He would pass! Desire Luzinda would pass for what now?
For drugs now.
So, you're just interested in Desire.
She has other problems, but not
Tony,
drugs.
Tony, tell that man, when a girl decides to take her clothes off for a person she don't know, and decides to take such photos, she clearly wasn't in her right
that
mental state.
That is not some alcohol height.
No, there was that something!
Some other height.
There was something in there, so she wouldn't pass. Well, it's been a good day. I've been chilling with these guys. Crazies always come out. We have Tony here and Kevin there. It's been our time. Besides that, do you have any plans for this weekend?
Yeah, sure. I have a birthday party I'm attending on Saturday.
Whatever. What are you doing?
It's a pool party. How many people organize birthday parties?
Alfresco. I can do that at my
You're
place
invited.
With a rubber duck in
You're
the bathtub.
Invited.
Topless what? Pool party? Or
yeah. Everything.
Did popular. You just have to go that direction?
No, see.
It could just be a party.
Desire is coming.
Oh,
Bego! Well, hey, that's all the time we could have. Are you finally on Twitter?
No.
Good Lord. At Kev_Diggy is his Twitter handle. Mine is at @CineFierce1. You can always hit us up. You can't DM us. Or you can catch us on Facebook. That's the Scoop and Scoop Facebook page. What?
How did you know what was good?
You're just one of those guys. It's been our time. I'm out. Let me teach this boy how to go on Twitter. I know it's hard.
Kind of thing.
He can't write. Bye. We out.